I walk a lonely road, the only one that I have ever known. Don't know where it goes, but it's home to me and I walk alone. I walk this empty street on the boulevard of broken dreams, where the city sleeps and I'm the only one and I walk alone.
We are on the dirt tracks, yes again.
Only with a slight twist this time.
Well, we stopped to catch up with the larder guys again, the one that we had the random milk and snacks and vodka in. We stopped yet again and we gave them some of our nuts and raisins because they seem quite into those. So we gave them that. We gave them a couple of straps as well because their battery was loose and they were trying to make it so it didn't bounce out of the car. The downside is that we were force-fed vodka. We didn't have any choice basically. So we're both, well, I don't know, we've had quite a few drinks, maybe a third of a cup between us, which isn't that much. But
more than that, probably about half a cup.
Half a cup on an empty stomach. So we're kind of driving on the terrain slightly more confident than we were before, which is, I don't know how to describe it. It's good fun now. The confidence is built up on this rough terrain.
This terrain is superb for the SJ. It's absolutely rocking over it. We're doing 30 miles an hour almost at the moment through this. We're trying to catch up with the Frontera in front.
We'll whip past that shortly and it'll be eating our dust.
No doubt. Larder though, it's quite difficult to cut.
Larder is doing 40-50 down here.
Yeah, we don't know how the larder is capable of doing that, but that's probably why his battery fell off anyway. But he just carries on once he's fixed it.
It is completely wasted though.
Yeah.
Completely.
It was quite interesting
drunk
watching
out
him.
His face.
Quite interesting watching him fix stuff while he was drunk. He couldn't even put a screw on straight. But he managed to fix it in the end and off he went.
He managed to wedge the live battery terminal in between a piece of wire and some kind of makeshift clamp. But he seems to be going and his car's pretty strong. Apparently he paid, how much for it?
$1,000.
$1,000?
They were quite jealous of the $600, £300 paid for our SJ and they wanted to buy it. They even offered us $2,000. And unfortunately we've got to get to Mongolia in it, so we had to decline that offer. He did try and buy our camo net earlier as well.
He also offered us $2,000 for our car, but unfortunately, if we did, then we wouldn't be able to get to Mongolia. After that, he suggested that, well, we could swap with the larder. Didn't really think that would be a
good move. Although we could potentially get to Mongolia with it, it looked in the right old state. It's probably the worst larder on the road that we've seen so far.
But it can cope with this.
Yeah, well, that's the amazing
40-50, I mean, how does that work?
Yeah.
The Frontera's lagging behind the larder. Crazy stuff.
We've been over some cousins for coming up to about a day now. We've been having dinner together and vodka. It's been good. But they've actually broken down. It looks like they've had some sort of gearbox failure. So our little SJ is now towing their car with the three of them. The SJ is performing surprisingly well considering the weight it has to bear.
So we're now heading to Kilzorda. We got to Maktobi in the end on that horrendous road. We were actually towing the larder guys for about 70 or 80 miles because their car broke down. Took them into Maktobi. We had a pretty good run, maybe 100 miles, maybe a bit less from Maktobi onto Kilzorda, and then suddenly straight in the middle of the road. We're going over one now. So it looks like it's off-road. Kilzorda, good. 1 mile away. So yeah, it's going to take a little while.
So we're now on the road to Shymkent with the intention of hopefully getting somewhere near Almaty tonight. If the roads are anything like they are at the moment, then we should hit it really.
Yeah. It is a bit warmly, but they're generally okay. Tarmac, no craters. We don't like craters.
No, craters bad.
Yeah.
It's about what? How many kilometres?
It's 275 kilometres from where we are. And then about another 700 kilometres from Shymkent to Almaty. Once we hit Almaty, we'll do a bit of a tour of the mountainous area there, and then head straight north for Russia and across into east into Mongolia.
Good stuff.
Our gearbox has been making some very odd sounds, so we have to stop in the middle of this rather unforgiving place. Just en route to Shymkent. We've just come out of Turkestan. You can see Alex here investigating the gearbox sound. We suspect it's down to a lack of order in the gearbox. So he's working on it hard in here. A lot of oil will be coming out of there shortly and going all over Alex probably. We've been avoiding doing this for a little while. But yeah, we've got to get it done now. We topped up the oil this morning. Everything seems to be running absolutely fine, really, in the car. It's just that the gearbox is making a bit of a funny sound. It was sounding a bit loose earlier, so we're going to check also all the wheels and everything.
What have we done today? Well, we have broken a leaf spring, buggered a prop shaft. Leaf spring was fine. We got one made up by some locals. Prop shaft we had to just remove, so now we're running in two-wheel drive, front-wheel drive, which is rubbish. That's about it really. We haven't done many miles, about 125 miles.
157 now.
157.
We're about 40 miles away from Shymkent. You can see my beard here. I haven't shaved in nearly 2 weeks, 2 weeks tomorrow. Oh yeah, I should mention it's sparkling mineral water that I'm shaving with, because there seems to be a shortage of still mineral water in this country.
I wouldn't do it in one go. I wouldn't even try it. Yeah. You want to do a bit at a time, because that's a serious amount of beardage.
Is it?
Yeah.
Well, I've never had to shave this much beard before, so we'll see how it goes.
It's going to cane.
Yeah, oh dear. Oh, we're out of sparkling mineral water, but we have more sparkling mineral water in the back of the car, because we only have sparkling mineral water. So. In fact, new bottle right here. What the hey! It nearly exploded on us. That's close.
The perils of sparkling mineral water.
Yeah.
Not only does it taste rubbish,
especially when it's warm,
but it gets back at you as well.
The whole shaving and sparkling water though, could be quite a good experience.
Might be really good for your skin.
Yeah, yeah.
Might be able to sell it as oxy shaving.
I've got a mirror right here as well. Perfectly located mirror. So, well, not perfectly, but it's as good as I'm going to get. Let's get this started. Ah. It's happening. It's happening.
That's gonna sting.
Oh dear. Just a bit more on this side here. You at home can see it all happening. Oh, I'm feeling better already.
Don't forget to leave the moustache there when you do it.
Oh yeah, yeah. Had a bit of a goatee for a while.
That's quite good like that actually. No?
No.
Shave your neck first, so you have like a proper beard.
Yeah, alright, well. My skin obviously didn't like the shave, because it's looking pretty bad. You should check this out.
Right, we're on our way to Almaty. We've made minimal progress today, minimal. A couple hundred miles of progress, if not even that actually.
170?
Yeah.
What's that?
We basically, as we said earlier, we lost our prop shaft earlier, it was totally knackered, and we lost our second leaf spring, that's on the passenger side. So we had to have one actually made up
by buying from a broker's yard or a car spares lead spring for a totally different car, taking it to a welder who chopped it and curved it down to size, and taking it to a fabricator to get it all in the right place and then fitted. Meanwhile, we had the prop shaft taken off, so we're running in permanent four-wheel drive, but with only the front two wheels actually moving. So it's a front-wheel drive car now, the SJ.
Rubbish.
Yeah. So 170 miles, and we decided we need to catch up, really, because we've lost a couple of days over the course since we've been in Kazakhstan. So we're just going to keep driving. So we bought this massive 2-litre bottle of Coke to keep us going. We've got loads of snacks in the back. Alex is our current designated driver. He hasn't driven all day, so he's fresh, ready to drive, and the road is pretty much pitch black, totally, you can hardly see the lines.
Well, we're doing a fairly decent speed there of about 40, 45 miles an hour.
So we're just going to keep heading to Almaty until we can take it no more.
We have plenty of snacks.
We had a bit of a crisis as we ran out of local currency. We only had about 1,400 tenge left, which is enough for about half a refuel in an expensive area, maybe slightly more. So luckily at Shymkent, where we just were, we found the petrol station that accepts a visa, supposedly. When we went in, their visa machine wasn't working. They spent half an hour, maybe 45 minutes, trying to get it to work. They didn't know how to operate it. Eventually, the guy behind the till agreed to swap out $50 at a rate of $1 to 115 tenge. And we paid for the petrol, got some snacks, and actually got some tenge left over, which gives us an allowance to refuel later on in case we do run out of petrol before we hit Almaty. Almaty is about 550 miles away. So, we'll give you another update later. Meanwhile, my rash from my shave earlier seems to be exactly the same, but what can you do? Anyway, looks like we're about to hit some sort of toll road, so over and out really. We're still on the road to Almaty after driving non-stop last night, pretty much. We stopped for about an hour and a half asleep. We've got to about 180 kilometers away from Almaty, and the scenery is already starting to improve dramatically.
Let's do that.
in between my fingers, it's in between my toes. This sand is all around me, but that's the way it goes.
Flying in the wind, it's everywhere I go. Oh, yes it is.
It's really damn annoying. Come on and brush it off.